Hey, good morning. It's Tim Archer. We are reading through the New Testament together on my blog at timothyarcher.com. I'm putting the readings for the week, and so you can follow along with us there. There's readings for Monday through Saturday. Sunday, you've got off. Spend time with your church, and also to catch up on anything you missed during the week. And so it's not a burdensome task to read this. It's a pretty easy reading to go through the New Testament, but it's important, I think, to read an amount, number one, that we're going to read and not get discouraged. Sometimes when we're trying to read a whole bunch, we give up pretty quick. The other thing is to have enough time to think about what we've read about. We're reading John chapter 8 today, starting in verse 31 to the end of the chapter. Jesus is talking with Jews that had believed in him, it says. Jews that believed in him. And it's interesting to see how quickly they turn against him and how quickly they end up at the point of wanting to kill him, picking up rocks to throw at him. It's amazing. And I think about our reaction to God's words. You know, part of their problem was nationalism, right? You know, that whole thing of we are Jews and we are Abraham's children, and how dare you say we're not free? And I hear echoes of my own countrymen saying, you know, our freedom was bought with the price of soldiers who died for us. And it's no, our freedom was bought with the blood of Jesus who died for us. That's our real freedom. That's what matters. That's our identity. We are Christians. We are Christians who happen to live in America. It's different from the people around us that don't believe in Jesus, but we are followers of Jesus. We are disciples of Jesus. And we have to be willing to accept whatever he says, even when it makes us uncomfortable, even when it bothers us. These people came to the point of accusing him of having a demon, saying he was a Samaritan, and all sorts of insults, and then finally trying to kill him. We don't go to that extreme usually, but we do try to find ways to get away from things that Jesus has said to us. We have to be willing, if we believe in him, to do what he says and follow where he leads. Let's pray. Father, we want to lift you up and praise you. We want to give you all the glory, and we want to pledge our allegiance to you and to you alone. Father, we pray for those that are dealing with sickness. We pray for those that have lost loved ones. I'm thinking about Phyllis Gilbert today and how hard, how fresh Bill's death is. And I pray that you be with her, but there's so many others that have lost loved ones recently, and I know that ache doesn't go away at all for many, but it certainly doesn't lose its sting for a time. And Father, I pray that you use us to console these people, and I pray that you use us, your church, to increase your glory, increase the recognition of your glory, and that you're known, your name be honored by all because of what your believers do in this community and each community where we live. Father, may we be yours and yours alone. We pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. I hope you have a great Monday.